Hello guys, welcome to another video. I'm gonna be doing another Yu-Gi-Oh! Master Duel because I have been stuck playing this game for an entire week. And here we go again with another Amazonian smackdown against Blue Eyes for the beginning of this video. As you see, he summons his alternative Blue Eyes and a maiden with blue. Maiden with eyes of blue. Then I just summon a whole bunch of Amazonian monsters. I activate Amazonian Call. Add Princess to my hand. Special summon Amazonian Spy by revealing an Amazonian monster. Special summon Baby Tiger due to having summoned an Amazonian. Then normal summon my Princess. Then I do like I did in the last video, take his monster's attack and add it to my own. Destroy it. That's his turn. See what he does. Okay, looks like he didn't do anything. There we go. I summon my trainer? Apprentice? I can't remember what it is. But it's great against the tuners of Blue Eyes because instead of sending monsters to the graveyard, it sends it back into the deck. Every time it destroys a monster, which is great against most of the tuners of Blue Eyes, except for in this case because he distributes to the graveyard and special summons Blue Eyes. An alternative destroys my monster, so there's that. He also destroys everything else, or mostly everything else on my field except for my spy. Now it's my turn again. I activate my trap card to bring an Amazonian back from the grave. Then activate its effect again. Or both of its effects. Of the Tiger and Princess. Again, Tiger gets special summoned from the graveyard or the hand because an Amazonian monster was summoned. Then I again take his monster's attack. However, I banish Amazonian Call due to its special ability to allow me to attack every monster on the field. So, as you can see, I'm going through it right now, destroying every single one of his monsters with my 3,200 attack that I stole from his Blue Eyes. Then, I use the four monsters up on the field to bring out a Borosword Dragon, my Link 4 monster. I, in this deck, only have a couple of Link monsters. It doesn't really fit perfectly with the deck, but it's better to use this monster because it negates and gains attack, so Blue Eyes can't really get over it that easy. Now it's my turn again, it's still his turn. I activate my trap to bring Amazonia Princess, which brings out the Tiger, and adds a spell trap card to my hand. I'm gonna add the call once again to my hand. Then it's my turn. I get call to bring out Sage. Activate Borosword to put my monster in defense mode. He changes his battle position, special summon Blue Eyes. He activates a spell card which negates the attack of my monster. However, he leaves himself open with a 0 attack point monster, and I have 1600 to win the game. Alright, now it's the next duel. This duel, I'm not going against Blue Eyes. I have no idea what this deck is called. But it has a lot to do with banishing, adding cards to your hand, and sending them to the, or putting them in the graveyard to special summon stuff. So, it's iffy if you get rid of stuff quickly, like I try to do here. But he Ash Blossoms Princess, which negates its effect. But I still have my spirit on the field, which grazes my attack by 1,000 when I attack a monster who has higher attack than my own. I end my turn, now it's back to him. He activates his monster since it is a graveyard. Gets the monster from his nether zone. Reveals the monster that he just brought to his hand, especially some of the ones he sent to the graveyard. I, however, activate my trap card that allows me to banish the monsters. And he then sends his monster to the graveyard, especially my fusion monster. I then send my princess to put in defense mode so I don't lose as much life points. And allow my monster to banish one of these. He then attacks me directly, but it's not that bad because it's still the beginning of the match. However, I only get a baby tiger, so it doesn't really help here, aside from the trap card that I have on the field. He then activates his monster effect to add another monster. He then attacks my baby tiger, however, my trap card activates, banishing his monster sitting onto the graveyard. Now, I draw, get Amazonian Princess, activate its effect, tiger activates, but he has torrential tribute. I try activating my trap card, thinking that it would save Princess by sending it to the graveyard, and then special summoning it back onto the field after torrential's done. However, that's not how timing works. It sends it to the graveyard and then just special summons back onto the field, which then brings it out for torrential tribute to destroy. But the tiger still survives. I don't get how that works, but it does. Now my baby tiger has 1100. He then activates his spell card, which banishes one of my spells of traps. So I don't have a banishing card anymore, but he still has no monsters on the field. I then activate my totem to keep my monster from being able to get destroyed by battle. Then he still doesn't bring it into the field. My turn, I tribute to bring out my queen, which then allows my tiger to special summon itself again, and attack me directly with both the queen and the baby tiger. And leaving him at 500. However, after this, he surrenders and I win the match. So it was great there. Now on to the third match. This match, again, using Amazonian because it's the only deck that I have that's completed, aside from the solo mode decks that you get from it, which I never use because they're incomplete and I don't want to try to fill them out with other cards. So using an Amazonian because it was the quickest thing I can get. But it looks like I'm going to be going against Mech Knights in this. He activates his Mech Knight to bring out his spell card. Activate my trap card, which is become the staple for my deck. Then adds another Mech Knight into his hand. Activates his spell card to send his Mech Knight to the graveyard to special summon his bigger. It's Mech Knight. I can't remember. Sorry. I can't remember. Is it Mech Knight? Or Mech Lord, I can't remember. No, it's Mech Lord because Mech Knights are the ones that can special summon. Special summon themselves into fields that have two things in the column, and I'm remembering them. Amazonian Claw into Sage. I then link off my Princess and my Spy to bring out my Verdant Anaconda. Then I activate my trap card to bring out my princess once again. I was trying to attack in order to get more damage out, but he, as you saw, used his quaking mirror force to send everything back into my hand and extra deck, so that was annoying. Then he regigies my sage, which allows me to special summon another monster due to my village. My village effect, if you guys don't know, if an Amazonian monster is into the graveyard at least once per turn, I get to special summon a Amazonian monster the same level from the deck. I then use my trap card to bring out Princess, to bring out Anaconda, which allows me to activate its effect, sacrificing 2,000 life points to fusion summon. I then fusion summon my Empress, then fusion recovery to bring a polymerization back into my hand, and one of the monsters that I used to summon to fusion. Attacking directly, with 35, then activate my spell card, just in case he ends up bringing another monster out that can destroy me. My turn again, I draw. I go in straight into the battle phase, thinking he doesn't have anything. He activates another mirror force, but my trap allows me to special summon the Zanga during the battle stage, and I end the match with 25. Well, there we go. I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. It's gonna be a little longer than the last time I did a Yu-Gi-Oh! Video. Again, I have been stuck playing this game. It's a problem. I've really been enjoying playing Master Duel, and I've been trying to actually make new decks for YouTube, so I can bring more variety instead of just bringing my Amazonian every time. For example, I've already started the bringing together of the silent archetype, i.e. the silent swordsman and the silent magicians, which hopefully, if everything works out the way I hope it does, should at least get me the same results as I am using my Amazonian decks, which is keeping me mid gold at the moment, because I am not using anything that's close to meta, because I still want to have fun. I'm not going to use any meta stuff aside from, like, if I want to put together a just messed up version of something. For example, I'm also trying to put together a Egyptian god deck and a tamer charmer. I think the only like meta thing that I'm putting together would be the beloved dolls. I believe that's like somewhat meta. I think I can't remember. It's been forever since I messed with it, so I might not put those together, but I do have enough cards to at least put something together for those. But, like I said, I'm going to try to put my Silent Swordsmans together, or the Silent Archetypes together first, before any of the others, because I have at least like 75% of those, or of that deck done, compared to like the 30 or 40% done of the other two or three that I have together. Especially the charmers, because for whatever reason, the only way you can get those cards are from the legacy cards, which you can only open those up and get two cards at a time. So those are annoying. But everything else, I should be able to at least get together. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and hopefully I can get other things together so I can at least have more fun in here and not just use my Amazonians every time. But yeah, bye, and I'll see you in the next one.